Hello, everyone. Welcome to part 14 of my Rockdale project with City Skylines. Last time I had that glitch on recording. It caused me to lose a few minutes of the game when I had a black screen situation where the game was still running, but I couldn't actually see it. So anyway, last time around, I cleared out this industrial area here, and I relocated it over here. Now, it's not completely jiggered the way I want it. What I need to do is I need to relocate this metro stop here. Now, theoretically I can relocate it, but you can't build a metro stop over top of an existing metro line, which means I have to first remove the stop. And then rebuild it where I actually want it. Okay, so let's see if I can put it where I want it exactly. Right, that's where I want it. So I rejoin those. Now I'll reset the stop that I removed. And there we go. Okay, now I can upgrade this road. Okay. And what I'm going to do also is push this through here and remove this crossroad, and also finish upgrading that one. What this does is it removes all the intersections along in front of the cargo station. So now I'm going to fill in the zoning and restart the simulation. Now I'm going to run it a bit faster for a moment here. Okay, so that seems to have made an impact on the traffic scenario a bit. By removing the crossroads here, it removes the traffic lights that were constructed there, and that actually substantially improves traffic flow. This situation here is definitely not ideal, but I don't really have a good solution for that at the moment. It's kind of the same problem here. But at least the traffic's moving. And that's helping. I suspect I can improve the traffic some by building cargo stations on the rail elsewhere than in the industrial. Anyway. I've clearly not exceeded the demand for industrial, so even though I've got a little bit less industrial here, it's actually not causing a pain here. So, what I'm going to do is rejigger things over here. Now, I can remove this road here, as it doesn't actually link up with the highway. I think I will change it so that it does, however. I'll go back to standard speed there. Lose the grid snapping. Okay, this ramp is way too long. So if I'm going to keep it, I'm going to just shorten it here. Now, I don't have room to do a proper interchange here. But I wonder if I can. No, I can't. Okay, so I can't do that without demolishing a bunch of stuff here. But what I can do is a partial diamond. Or not that way. Okay. Okay. Partial diamond. And how do I, how can I deal with the rest of it? I would have to demolish stuff. I think perhaps. Yeah, I'm going to leave that alone. So this road, I'm going to bring it around this way and hit the highway here. So, I'm going to need to build a bridge. And I'm going to have an interchange here. Okay, now I need to reverse the ramps here. Okay, now okay, so I can get rid of this one-way malarkey here. And over here, since it doesn't actually go anywhere, okay. I can get rid of this malarkey here. Okay. And what I'll do is bring a road off of here. Okay. Okay. That greatly simplifies that mess. Okay. Now, Okay, I need to smooth that out. Actually, this business here, I can just take it out and turn it into a regular diamond interchange now. I have nothing in the way. So I can just build a straight road out here. Then I can bend this one around like so. Okay. Nope. That'll do. Okay. Now I build the ramps here. Okay, good. Okay, so that straightens out a bit of a mess there. I may have to realign this to match my grid over here. Anyway, oops. Okay. Now, okay, yeah, it wasn't quite square on, so yeah, that's pretty much what I needed to do there. This particular long block is a little bit longer than the others. There's clearly some glitches with de-zoning. Okay, what I'm gonna do here is bend the big road around. Like so. Okay. Okay, so far so good. Now, on this side of the ah, yes, I put the wrong road type here. Okay. Okay, let's see if that traffic clears. Where is it going? Okay, it did clear. Right, okay. I'm going to upgrade this road and this one. Do one more thing here. I am going to remove that intersection. Wait a minute, what's the zoning look like there? Okay. So by removing that, I should remove one bit of the bottleneck. Should get more of the traffic on the bigger road. Okay. Excellent. So, I will bring some water into here. Okay. Now, for some zoning. Actually, no, I want commercial there. And there, gonna make some offices along here. Okay. I'm not sure how I'm going to fill this in since I've got these angles here. I suspect I'll probably need a roundabout in here. Okay, so how's my new industrial area over here doing? Okay, I still have this massive abandonment thing here. Okay, so while I'm fiddling around there, I'm going to push the Grove Hills district up to the big road. And I'll keep this boundary the way it is. This one will fill in like so. Okay. Whoops. Okay. Okay. I'll expand Smoky Woods to include everything here. Okay. So far, so good. Now, okay. Okay, and add some water in there. Okay, first off, I need to bring this water pipe across. Okay, and now for something completely the same, more plumbing. Okay. Okay, so that pretty much links up the rest of, like, links up the city development here. I've probably overzoned on the commercial and office zoning there. But it seems like it's probably something that will be needed eventually. What I'm going to do though, is I'm going to upgrade some of these to high density. That should cover some demand for residential without having to build more roads. And I think it's probably a good idea to bash in a park. And maybe some education. Okay, that will probably help as well. Now, let's see what demographics are doing. Well, that's certainly an improvement. I think I should Now, the other way. Okay. Well, I'm going to expand the residential over here. Okay. Okay, so now that I've created some additional roads here, okay. Okay, with that, I no longer need this power line, so I'll remove it. There we go. Okay, so I've got a something of a plateau going on here. where the population is staying pretty stubborn around 62 or 63,000. And I've got a fair amount of building abandonment going on here. So it seems to me that I have clearly not designed a city sanely. It's almost certainly a transportation issue. So I'm going to probably play around with additional transportation options in the next part. Well, I'll put an incinerator over here. And over here. Not an incinerator, crematorium. I wonder if some amount of the population issue is inconvenient access to handling the death care. So where's the next milestone? 65,000. Well, it looks like I have a similar problem over here. Okay, so I'm gonna stick a landfill over here just for some giggles. And a cemetery seems like a reasonable thing to do as well. Ah, here we go. Finally hit the metropolis. So, with that, I'm going to call this apart. That's it for part 14. I'll see you all back for part 15. Thank you for watching.